I'm just gonna let everybody in and we're gonna get started.
Hello.
Hi there. How are you today?
Hi, I'm good. How are you?
Very good.
This is Dawn Peary. Let me see it. I guess I need to start my video.
Okay. Welcome, Dawn. Welcome.
Hi. I've been waiting for this.
Oh, great. We're so happy to have you. We're so happy to have you.
I've used Elizabeth Arden for a long time.
Oh, great. And we're going to have a great conversation.
Yeah, but it's like my skin changed after I was sick a couple years ago. And I've really been using just all my sample stuff I get when I order my makeup.
But
yeah, I'm really anxious to have a decent skincare because my skin, I just noticed it's really changing now.
I can relate, Dawn. I certainly can relate. So we'll definitely make sure to get some of your concerns addressed for sure.
And hi, this is Lori. Hi.
Hi, Lori.
I've been using your ceramides for probably close to 18 years.
I love that, Lori.
Yes.
I love that.
Yeah.
One of my favorite products.
Yeah, they're real. It's done wonders with my skin. Like,
and it does. It does. Definitely makes a difference. For sure.
I don't have wrinkles around my eyes anymore.
Hey, how you like that?
People have a hard time with my age. So, yeah.
That's not a problem. That's a good problem.
I just need to know what to put on first.
Gotcha.
We're going to get into it.
Yeah, we'll definitely talk about regimen. Hello there, Carol and Yermina.
Hi. I love it.
Hello, I see your lovely faces.
Welcome. Can you hear me?
I can hear you, dear.
I not only been using Elizabeth Arden forever, but I also was one of your counter managers in Albany, yeah, New York.
Oh, lovely.
Yeah, so I've been obviously using it forever. But
You're part of the family.
Indeed. And the question that I have now is sort of similar in some ways that my skin is I never admit my age, but I'm over 70. And I've been using Provage, and then the ceramic capsules at night. And I just want to know if I should be using for a moisturizer. Everything else will be Provage, but I do the Premier Eye Cream, and I switch to the Premier Day. And okay. I want to know which one is better for deeper wrinkles. And I really can't answer it anymore. So is it the Ceramide Day Premier, or is it go back to the Provage Day Cream? That's why I'm here.
Okay. So that's a great question. I can tell you off the bat, Premier, definitely, because what you're experiencing is the loss of, you know, it's that decade you're in, right? So Premier is the most nourishing and replenishing of those key ingredients. But we'll definitely talk through some of those things. And I see you guys are anxious with questions. So I'm so happy to have you here. But we're going to turn it over to Melissa just to get us started.
So welcome. I'm so glad you guys have your camera on. As Sasha said, my name is Melissa, and I'm part of the U.S. Elizabeth Arden Education Team, and I'm thrilled to have our very special guest. She is the head of North America Education. She's our director of education, and she is an esthetician, and she has been with Elizabeth Arden in multiple different roles, including in a spa room at a Red Door Spa. Her name is Tashiana Baker. You can call her Tosh for short. But we're very excited here to talk to you guys today. And this is where, you know, it's always nerve-wracking to talk to an esthetician because they're kind of like a doctor, right? They can look at your skin and they know a lot about you very quickly. And so that's what we want to get through today. We want to answer all of your questions. So as you have questions, if you want to put them in the chat, that's great. We'll have time for questions at the end. But we really want to talk through some of the things that people struggle with skincare. And where I want to start with Tosh is I want to throw it to her and ask her, when it came to career day at school, why did you go down this road of wanting to be an esthetician, choosing skincare as your career? Because I want to start there because that's really the important piece for most people who do this in this business.
Yeah, I think that's a great question. First of all, nice to see you all. I think everybody's journey, kind of how they got there, is interesting. So, and it helps you know me a little bit. So let me just say, at career day at school, esthetician was not on my radar at all. I was a writer since I was 9 years old. And so I thought I wanted to write. I went to college for journalism. I was working in another field completely for 7 years before I realized that I didn't love what I was doing. And fortunately for me, I had a job at an insurance company that had great benefits that allowed me to pay to go to aesthetic school part-time while I worked my full-time job. And then I transitioned out of that job that I hated. And my first job was at the Elizabeth Arden Red Door Spa 17 years ago. And so I've been an esthetician for 17 years now, and I've been in education for aesthetics for 15 years. And when I say why, it's because how many of you can relate to having an important meeting or a special occasion, and you wake up and you got, you know, a blotch or a juicy pimple or, you know, some weird rash going on? I was always very keenly aware of how people felt about how their skin looked. And I wanted to be a part of the team of people that can meet people where they are, help them understand what's going on with themselves, make different changes like their skin coach to kind of get their skin to optimal beauty for them, right? And kind of get out of this cookie cutter thing, right? And so for me, it was your confidence, how you feel when you show up in the world looking your best. I've always been attached to that. So that's why I love skin. And that's why I haven't been able to, you know, leave it. This is my life now.
I'm with you. It's definitely, it's very emotional to be in this type of role because our faces are so important to us. So yeah, yes. I definitely can relate to that, why I'm in this role and why I love my job so much as well. So, and one of the things that I want to ask you first, before we jump into individual concerns and the questions, is I want to just get it out there. What are the most common mistakes that people make when it comes to their skincare? So I feel like that's something we don't talk about enough.
Yeah. And so, and I think this relates to the kind of questions, ladies, that you already started asking. It's that we think we don't need a routine, and we think we can cherry pick products and use them here and there. And then we have a good skin day, and then we stop using our products. And the reality is that your skin is alive. It's dynamic. It's changing with your emotions. It's changing with your hormones. It's changing with your moods. And it's also constantly interacting with your external environment. And so one of the biggest mistakes that I see people is that they don't get on a good routine. They skip cleansing and skip to treatment, or they skip, you know, they do cleansing and treatment, but they don't do moisturizing. They skip sun protection, big no-no. So it's, you have to find a routine that works for your skin, works for your lifestyle, for your budget, and you got to stick to it. Because part of it is just habit. You know, it's kind of like brushing our teeth, right? It's habit. Part of it is just habit. And then it's getting the product in the place that you can use it and enjoy the benefits, right? So it's that. It's helping you find what works for you.
That's a good one. And I'm definitely guilty of that one, as you know. So, and that's important. And, you know, I'm going to add on what you just said, because I think that the routine is super important. And what somebody already talked about is evolving your routine.
Yes.
That's super. Yes. That's another piece that I'm like, that's a mistake a lot of people make if they're not getting progress. And then it's like, how do you change it up?
And so that's because our skin is changing, right? Yeah. And so, you know, what worked for us 10 years ago may not work for us now, or it may need a bump up or a boost, some different things. You know, we talk about that all the time, right, Melissa, where we cycle some more active ingredients to kind of keep our skin guessing. And then we cycle down and nourish and hydrate to keep our skin replenished and restored. And sometimes you got to do that. It's like a good relationship. You got to keep your skin guessing.
Yeah, absolutely. So we get the mistakes, we get that is a lot of stop start that causes our issues. Yeah. What are, like, if we could give everybody three things that are must do's, what are our three must do's for healthy skin? And then we're going to get into some of the specifics questions and make sure that we are addressing each of these pieces so that you get all of your questions answered and that we're really walking away from this time with you,
awesome, understanding
what we've got to do to have the best skin possible.
So your three must-dos is, a lot of people try to cheat themselves on their cleansing habits. you have to cleanse your skin because you're exposed to so many environmental factors and things that you're not aware of at a microscopic level. And then what happens is your skin is overloaded with those toxins and impurities, and then it can't quite nourish and replenish because you have a lot of things blocking. So I would say a good cleansing routine and then a good hydration routine. So your skin at its healthiest state has a good balance of oil and water. And so as we age, it changes. Certain ethnic groups, cause us to be, imbalanced in that way. Our habits and our lifestyle will imbalance our moisture balance. So a good moisture balancing product that helps your water balance and your oil balance. And then your third step, essential for everybody, I don't care what age, what complexion, what have you, is your sun protection. Because, a lot of people say, well, my grandmother didn't use sun protection. Well, our environment is not like your grandmother's environment. The world is different for us now with the ozone layer and the amount of radiation we get from the sun. The sun is different. And so we have people who have great genetic makeups who are seeing their skin change too because of the environment. So I would say cleansing routine, hydration and moisture balance routine, and then your sun protection. Those are your three. I don't care what, you got to do those every day, day and night, keeping in mind your skin is protecting you during the day for most of our schedules, right? You're out in the world, so you got to do maximum for protection during the day and then maximum for restoration and replenishment at night, because our body, when we rest, repairs itself. So you should do those three things day and night.
Yeah. And so I want to just pause for a second and take some questions from our guests today. Anybody watching have any questions so far for Tosh that you feel like, okay, so I'm definitely doing something wrong, or I'm doing those three things and I'm still not getting the results I want. I see somebody took themselves off mute. What questions do you have? Nope. No. Okay. Any questions? Go ahead.
I'm sorry. Actually, I do have a question. I never know what product to use first. So if I'm using the ceramides and I'm using the hyaluronic acid I use them morning and night, but after I cleanse my face, I never know which one to put on first.
So that's a great question. I think that was Lori, right? That's a great question. And it's a common thing, right? We are becoming more sophisticated in treating a couple of different issues. So if you have a couple of different serums, like a hyaluronic, like our hyaluronic capsules, for example, or you have your ceramide capsules, for example, you always go lightest texture to heaviest texture. So you want to do hyaluronic first in this example, then you would do your ceramide advanced capsules, so second, if you were using them as layers. But anytime you have any product, right, you're always wanting to go from the lightest weight, most likely water-based, and then build on the weight next to, the next weight and perhaps your oils, so light to heavy oils. And then you always want to seal in your serums with a moisturizer. It's a non-negotiable. Even if your serum has a oil content to it, it is designed to absorb it and it doesn't sit on the surface to protect. So your moisturizer is designed to give you protection on the surface. Okay. So lightest weight serum to heaviest, and then sealed in with a moisturizer.
Perfect. Thank you.
You're very welcome.
Another question? Go ahead, Doc.
Yes. I have a question. I never know there are so many of the ceramides out there with you. I mean, the retinol, you have vitamin C, you got everything. Yeah. My question is, I guess what's going to be the best for my skin and what I should use based on my own like dryness, like my under my eyes is extremely dry. It's almost like when I put on concealer, you can see it like the flakes, like skin, and it's, so it's like, I don't know which ones I should use for mine. And the same as the lady just said, what do you use first? Because there's so many different things to use.
So here's the thing, Dawn, when we are dry or dehydrated, and that means lacking oil or water, you always want to address that first. Okay. Always want to address the moisture barrier first, because when the moisture barrier is compromised, you're not going to absorb and process most of your other ingredients quite as well. So we always want to hydrate and moisturize first. So my focus for you would be a routine that's really focused on oil replenishment, ceramide replenishment, barrier repair, right? And so you would do that, for example, a couple, you know, three times a week, Dawn, right? That would be your commitment, say Monday, Wednesday, and Friday. And then if you were interested in addressing the fine lines and wrinkles, you would use the retinol capsule at night a couple nights a week. You understand? Yeah. So you want to focus, you want to always pick your top 2 to 3 concerns and address them in the order of importance. Dryness and moisture is always first because your skin is compromised. That means you're more prone to sensitivity. You're not going to wear your makeup as well. Your skin is thirsty, so it's pulling in ingredients and products that it shouldn't be drinking because it's just so thirsty. So you have to address that first. And then once you address that, you start to get more suppleness. You're not dry or flaky. Then you can add in other active ingredients like our retinol capsule or like our vitamin C capsule to address your lines and wrinkles for retinol or brightening for vitamin C. Those are your actives. So those are what we call targeted solutions, but you really want to make sure your skin health is optimized first. Okay.
Right.
And then one other thing, and I don't want to throw a lot of products at you, but it's one of my favorite products. It's our Superstar skin renewal booster. When you have that drying and flakiness, right, and your barrier is compromised, this is one of the best products out there, honestly, you guys. Even I'm a little biased, but Superstar is excellent because it's really trying to get your probiotics up. It's giving you the microbiome. So, you know, we don't like to think about the fact that we have little germ, you know, bugs that live on our skin, but they're there to protect us. So when we're dry and flaky, it means that your skin can't protect you as well. If you use your Superstar first on clean skin, then any of the capsules, it can be your moisturizer and then, you know, your serum second, okay? I don't want to make it too complicated, but it depends on how savvy you want to be. I would say for you, focus on moisture barrier first and then address some of the other issues you might see changing, like lack of brightness, fine lines, wrinkles, that kind of thing, okay?
Yes, I'm willing to do whatever I need to do. So
I love to hear that.
I just want someone to tell me what to do so I can follow the regimen.
Absolutely. And so we will be having these master classes often, guys. So you're welcome to come back and keep me abreast of how you're doing. I won't disappear on you. So I would say start today, Dawn. So focused on your moisture barrier and at least 3 times a week, day and night, that ceramide, advanced ceramide capsule before your moisturizer is going to replenish that. And then focus on the other things you like to change in those couple days. Okay.
How often would you use the Superstar booster? Would it be morning and night and every day?
Yes, it would be morning and night on clean skin before your other treatment serums, because it really helps the moisture barrier, the probiotics in there. It opens up the skin's water channels. It does a lot, right? It's just a phenomenal product that's really not always as understood or, you know, by people, but it's one of my favorites because it solves a lot of our skin sins.
You know, it's one of my favorites, Tasha. If I have maskne, if I wore a mask for too long, or even just weather changes, Superstar is the game changer for me. It balances my skin so quickly and really does help my other products work better. So
it really does.
I'm going to give you a question from the chat. And this is about hyperpigmentation and uneven skin tone and what products we would recommend for hyperpigmentation and really addressing that discoloration in the skin.
So a lot of times people don't think about the first and most important product to address hyperpigmentation, which is your sun protection. Because any product that we would give you to help to brighten and balance the complexion won't really do appreciated results if you're constantly going out getting that sun, which is creating the pigment. Okay, so the first thing I would say is daily sun protection. Find a sunscreen product that you love, that you don't mind reapplying. That's the first line of defense. The second line of defense would be like our vitamin C capsules. You want skin brighteners. You want things that actually send signals down to your pigment cells to not overproduce, okay? Another great serum we have that is great for hyperpigmentation is Provage 2.0, because some of our hyperpigmentation is from our environmental and sun damage and you know, photo damage, as we call it, right? And so the Provage 2.0, you use that consistently daily. And it will help to brighten the overall complexion and even out the skin tones. Now, I'm going to name serums. Let me tell you why. Your serums are your workhorse of your regimen, okay? So you always want to have clean skin. Then you want your treatment serums to go in. They're concentrated in the active ingredients to go in and create the change you want to see. And then your moisturizers are your protectors or your replenishers, depending on if they're day or night, okay? So brightening through our vitamin C is a good solution. Brightening through our Provage 2.0 is a good solution. You could even do our Provage Progressive Renewal Treatment, which is kind of like what we would do in the spa. We would do a chemical peel, but this is a mild alpha hydroxy and polyhydroxy acid peel. And it progresses over each week if you're into an intensive program. I'm trying to think of one other product that popped in my mind. Oh, for hyperpigmentation, and I don't want to overwhelm you guys, but you see, I get really excited about this, right? Our retinol capsules. So the reason retinol is amazing is because it addresses hyperpigmentation in addition to texture and in addition to poor health. So retinol is a great ingredient, right? It would take a little longer if you're talking about specific spots and blotches. So you want to pair it as a night serum and do something else supporting it during the day, like the vitamin C or the Provage 2.0 that I mentioned, but retinol is a great product that also has the benefit of brightening and helping hyperpigmentation. One of the things that you wanna be careful of if you are someone who gets that pigmentation is that your skin is not dehydrated, because we're finding that dehydrated skin gets more inflamed and the inflammation triggers pigment, right? So we wanna make sure that the skin health, I told you, good cleansing, good moisture balance, good protection. You want to pay attention to that and then add your brightening specialties in there. Okay.
I want to add a question in here, Tosh, because I think you've recommended some of like my favorite products.
Yes.
You are really on the nose in terms of like how to get results. So if I was just starting one of these today, how long will it take for me to see results? Like, what is the timeline look like? And how do I really measure the progress? Because I think that's important. People want instant gratification.
Yes.
Can't blame them. But yes, at the same time, we know that this is a long game, not a short game. So
it is. And so we're a microwave society, right? We want everything in an instant. But what you have to understand is the main things that are showing up causing visible change on your skin didn't happen overnight either, okay? So in normal, healthy, young skin, ladies, right? So I'm not judging, right? I'm just going to tell you the facts. It's about 28 days to take your cell from its basement layer to the surface layer. As we age, that cell renewal cycle slows down. I've seen some clients whose skin has gotten so sluggish that it takes as much as 90 days for them to slough off and have new and renewed skin. That's why retinol is such a favorite ingredient, because it actually helps to accelerate your cell turnover and keep it accelerating quickly. However, to answer the question specifically, products like your hydrators, your plumpers, those are more immediate. Anything that has your acids for smoothing and exfoliating, those are kind of 1 to 2 uses. You're going to see a result, right? You're going to see an immediate result. Now, some of our serums do have hydrating elements in them as well. So you don't need something separate for hydration, right? So you're going to see some immediate benefit of using it. However, long-term change and long-term results, you want to give it at least 4 to 6 weeks of consistent use. And if you have a product problem that is chronic and ongoing, you want to give it as much as 6 to 12 weeks. And it doesn't matter what product that is, that's just playing with your natural cell renewal cycle so that we're feeding the skin cells in the basement, training them on how we want them to look, but then we got to give it time to come to the surface.
That's a great way to look at it. I love that analogy of it. So how often should I get a facial? And I know part of that answer will have to do with how good is your skincare routine? How often right. should you get a facial? Is another
right.
question.
So that's a trick question. But let's just say at minimum, right, guys, I would love to see my clients quarterly, every change of season, just to check in, just to see how their skin health is. I do, you know, we all estheticians do a visible assessment of the skin, make sure there's no sun damage that needs to take a look, be seen by a derm, any blotches or anything like that. We try to stay in touch with you for your overall health as well as your skin health, right? So once a season is ideal. However, once a month, if you're in a routine addressing a problem. However, your facial is only 20% of the long game. 80% of your results in your skin's appearance is going to come from your daily use of products at home, because that's daily change. That's daily nutrients. So people who don't use products at home is like the people who go to the gym, you know, once or twice a year, and then they don't eat a good diet. The good diet for your skin is your products, right? So, and then you come for your skin coaching and assessment with your esthetician, you know? And so it's a partnership. I would say it's almost as important. Some people say more important. I don't know. Depending on what day you ask me, I would even say more important than brushing your teeth and flossing your teeth, right? So you go for your regular checkup with your dentist. That's like your facial. And then you use your daily, you know, toothbrush, toothpaste, and dental floss at home. Same thing as your skin regimen.
Thank you. I appreciate that. I just want to add something onto it. Yes. When I was in my 20s, my sister-in-law would complain to me that I had a tremendous amount of wrinkles around my eyes. Mm-hmm. And I am now 75. Mm-hmm. And because I've used Elizabeth Arden for 15, 18 years, and I've used the ceramides, I'm just starting to use the hyaluronic acid and the retinol. Okay. But since I've been using the ceramides, those wrinkles all disappear. Mm-hmm. And yeah, it did happen over time, but I'm like, holy moly, I can't believe it. Actually, they went away.
I believe it, Linda. I believe it. Or is that Carol that said it? I'm sorry.
It was Lori.
Lori, I'm sorry, honey. I didn't mean to call you by a different name. Believe it. Let me tell you why. The ceramides that we've included in our formulas mimic the natural ceramides that we lose with age. They're a part of your natural moisture factor in your skin, like when we're babies. So you remaining committed to replenishing means that your skin doesn't get a chance to crease and crack and those kinds of things, right? And so that does make a difference. It's not a gimmick, guys. I promise you, I've committed my career to this because it creates real change in your skin. And that affects how you feel you show up in the world, for sure. So I'm so happy to hear that, because that's what we want for you, Lori, for sure.
You're getting some kudos in the chat that you look great, by the way.
Yes, Lori, give
a
shout out.
How good you look. Melissa, and I like your hair color.
Oh, thank you. So I wanted to take us back to retinol for a second, because we have somebody asking about emerging wrinkles. And I watched kind of myth bust that, like, retinol is not age-related, technically. It is more concerned. It's a big myth in the skincare world.
Yeah. And so it's funny, because I think I'm going to have to do a whole masterclass on the myths around retinol, guys. So you'll have to come back for that. But I will say quickly, retinol is such a great ingredient. And the reason you hear so much buzz around it is because it's not age specific. It really is trying to keep the skin optimally healthy, right? And so that's everything from preventing acne breakouts, poor congestion, sluggish cell turnover, loss of skin tone and elasticity, all of those issues that could happen at any age and stage of your life, depending on what's going on. And so that's why retinol is the go-to ingredient. And so if you are starting to see early signs of lines and wrinkles, you do want to focus on, and our retinol is great because it has a ceramide right in the capsule with it, right? So you're replenishing the moisture balance, but then you're also getting a retinol that is very powerful and encapsulated to be effective for the line smoothing results that you want. So it's not an age specific, you don't have to wait until you have, you know, deep lines or deep creases. You want to get ahead of that and start to stimulate your collagen and stimulate that turnover. And it really does get rid of those emerging lines and delay it. Lori told you, those ceramides plus now that retinol, that'll make a difference for you.
Yeah, agreed. And then we have a question about under eye bags. And again, I'm gonna go back to a retinol product. I think that big star ingredient, niacinamide, that's in our retinol eye cream is a really big one for eye bags and could really make a difference. Tosh, do you have any other recommendations for eye bags? I think that's my favorite.
That's my favorite product, but I will say, look at your sleeping habits, because as much as I'm about great products, guys, your habits matter. So what we see a lot of times is if you're getting not enough uninterrupted sleep, your body's REM sleep, the deep sleep, it has a pumping that it gentle, if you were to look at you while you were sleeping, your eyes flutter gently, and that creates a pumping sensation through this area, right? So that your lymph fluid is pumping out towards, you know, the lymph drainage, right? So when we get good sleep, our body mechanisms pump excess fluid from our face. When we don't get good sleep, guess what? It's sitting right there. So yes, the retinol liner line smoothing eye cream is amazing. If you're, you know, and the niacinamide helps the capillary network to clear that out and kind of depuff and brighten that area as well. But you got to look at your habits as well.
Can I ask a question?
I see Ms. Carol raising her hand.
Yeah. And hello everyone. And I'm sorry. I feel like I'm being selfish. I've got to go to a meeting. And I gotta
go.
So real quick, I've been doing is I'm just giving you the day and the night and tell me what I should add there. That's why I'm on here, as I said earlier. So what I cleanse and super start eating it the morning and night. But the daytime I'm using just a light cleanser. I'm using the 2.0. I'm using the Premier Eye, and then I'm using the Premier Day. And then during the night is I use the Provage Booster, which I love. Mm-hmm. And then I'm using the Ceramide Advanced Capsule, then the Premier Eye and the Premier, and excuse me, and the Provage Night. What should I add? And one of the things I said, my question was that I'm about to buy a moisturizer and you've got your great special, the Flash Sale.
You saw that.
You beat me to it.
Yeah, good timing. First question, really with that is, as I said, Jude, I'm about to buy a moisturizer, the spring, summer. I am recuperating from 2 hip operations. I'm 74.
Oh my gosh. And
I don't know whether to do the Premier Day continue or the Provage Day. Provage Day. I don't know if I've seen much of a difference. It's just which one is better for me at you know, from what I had just said.
So each are very good in different ways, Ms. Carol. I would say when you are using your Provage 2.0, you could switch it just a little bit by doing your Provage cream as your moisturizer instead of your Premier, right? Okay. And then when you're doing your Advanced Capsule, then do your Premier as the chaser for that, okay? Yep. Just to keep that skin guessing a little bit. But the Provage ingredient story is just a tad different than the Premier ingredient story. And it's gonna change the skin a little bit differently. Whereas Premier is really about nourishing, replenishing nutrients that are lost. You're gonna be able to amp up a little bit more change in your skin by adding either Provage Day and Day with 2.0 or Provage Night at Night with 2.0, however you decide to do it, right? Okay. Whenever you're using your Provage 2.0, your Provage cream, and then your Advanced Capsule with your Premier cream.
Oh, interesting. Okay. All right. Good. And then so deeper, used to be fine lines. And thank God, you know, my skin is, everyone said, oh, you don't look your age. Yes, same with you next to me. Up there. And I always say, well, it's sort of, you know, Provage and Ceramide. So that's it, is that I now don't have fine lines, but I'm animated, right. And I've got, and they're deeper. So stick with what you said or get off.
Now, to be completely honest, I would want to put your skin on a little bit of a workout, Miss Carol, and add that retinol capsule in a couple times, couple nights a week, because that is going to, remember I said that cell turnover cycle is important. So we want to keep that at rotating at a younger state. It also stimulates collagen as well. So that would be the thing that could put your skin on a little bit of a treadmill. You start a couple nights a week and work up and see how you do. You could potentially do it every night if your skin is resilient. That'd be a good way to kind of just amp it up a little bit.
And it would be at night, it would be the Ceramide Advance first and then the retinol capsule, or the other way around?
Retinol capsule on closest to your skin. Wait, allow that to dry down, and then you would seal with Advanced Capsule and then your night cream.
Yeah, thank you. Thank
you. You're welcome. Very welcome. Questions. Have a great day. It was a great question.
Thanks.
Okay. Hey, go ahead. Who's the next question?
I can go if nobody else asks me.
Go ahead, honey. Go ahead.
Okay. I'm in the 70 plus club here, so it looks like
I'm
on here. So I thought I'd ask a question. So I've been using Elizabeth Arden for a long time, but it's so many products to choose from. So right now I'm using an anti-aging daily cleanser with the bees in it. Mm-hmm. Hyaluronic acid. Did I pronounce that right?
Hyaluronic acid.
Mm-hmm. Serum.
Okay.
Anti-aging serum and anti-aging daily moisturizer.
Okay.
offer. So when I'm playing golf or I'm playing pickleball or something like that, I add the City Smart thing, you know, supposed to be the sunscreen, right?
Yes, it is a sunscreen. Yes.
Sometimes I'm thinking I'm just using too much. And then I'm using the cleanser again, the retinol, the anti-aging serum, and then the anti-aging night cream, night moisturizer.
Okay.
But I'm thinking sometimes that you just do too much.
No, actually, you have a very complete regimen. The only thing you didn't name is your eye cream, eye products, which you should have eye products as well. And I didn't catch your name, but when's the last time you had a facial?
Oh, last time I had a facial, it's been a while. I need one.
I believe, because here's what happens, guys. Sometimes you're just time for good maintenance, okay? So it's time for a good, you know, tune-up, so to speak. So your facials are your tune-ups to your regimen. And then a lot of times, because the facial includes deep bore cleansing, exfoliation, rehydration, treatment, and that kind of thing, that is a good reset for your skin health. And then your products are good maintenance. So your skin care is you're only going to do but so much at home, guys. You still have to go and get some tune-ups here, right? I think you might need a tune-up. Because your regimen sounds very complete. Now, obviously, I'm not looking at you close enough to assess also some other things that you could do, but you have a very complete basic regimen for someone at your stage and age. And I think you need a tune-up to then assess, are those daytime products best for daytime? And are those nighttime products perhaps best for nighttime? Or could you, you know, put your skin on a little more active routine or, you know, switch it up a little bit. I can't really assess that based on what you told me. My recommendation is go get a tune-up, treat yourself, and let somebody take a closer look and see what's going on, because you do have a good care regimen there.
Okay. The Ceramide Lift and Firm Cream.
Mm-hmm. Yes.
Can I get that instead of moisturizer?
That is your moisturizer, sweetheart. That's your moisturizer.
I switched that from the anti-aging daily moisturizer. It'll be okay then.
Yes. It's got a little more weight to it. And it's a little more age appropriate, just off age alone. So I think you might enjoy that.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
And City Smart, I would say I don't know where in the world you are, but it's a good when it's warm outside and more intense, you know, humidity, that kind of thing.
Yeah. Okay.
Okay. So you might just have to rotate off of certain textures depending on the time of year and things like that as well.
Mm-hmm. Okay.
You're all very right. Well. You good? You good?
I'm good. I think I'm going to switch to a Ceramide Lift and Firm for a little while.
Okay.
Moisturizer, the anti-aging daily moisturizer. So I think I'm going
to. Yeah. I think that would be a good switch for you just from the sounds of it.
Okay.
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 I love that night cream. It's one of my favorite night creams.
The night cream is
the Lift and Firm night cream is amazing. Yeah. Somebody's asking about a neck cream. And I know that's another area we often neglect, especially the back of the neck. So I'm going to throw that to you, and you can share a little bit more about our options around neck cream and really why that's like so important.
Well, you should be treating that area, you know, all the way down to my neckline, right? So this is the entire skin treatment area. And around the back of your neck as well, right? Our neck skin will start to show age differently because the muscles of our neck run this way. And so we usually see loss of elasticity and tone in here. We have a neck and deck cream specifically for that area because it is nutrient replenishing for that area. But let me just say again, our retinol capsule, because you want to control, you know, the line smoothing, retexturizing and cell renewal in that area as well. So whenever you're doing your capsules, guys, when you're applying over your face and down around your neck. Okay. So you don't have to make it look as like how I have trained hands, right? But you should treat yourself by bringing your product all the way down around your neck. Okay. So you do a serum for the line smoothing effect, like our retinol capsule, and then our cream, like our neck and deck cream, would be great cream for you. That's short for neck and décolleté. Sorry, guys. We get nicknames for our products, but that cream is specifically for neck and décolleté.
And then somebody's asking about the Privage Anti-Aging Foundation. So we have several makeup products that are going through innovation and changes. If you're looking for a foundation right now, I cannot recommend enough our flawless finish, our skin caring foundation. And that is another foundation that has skin caring benefits in it. So it's 88% skincare based ingredients, and it does have 24 hour wear and buildable coverage if you haven't tried it. I know Tosh is one of your favorites, and we were just talking about foundation before this. So yep. Is there any other foundations right now that you would recommend that would be comparable to our Privage Anti-Aging?
No, I think skin caring is really comparable. And I would say for great wear of that foundation, you want to make sure your skin's hydrated and moisturized underneath. So even when you find a great type of foundation you love, you can't neglect the moisture balance and on the skin, because you'll wear foundation better throughout the day with good balanced moisture on your skin. Yeah.
Okay, could you please tell me the name of that moisturizer, that foundation again? I'm sorry, I didn't hear.
Oh, yeah, of course. It's the Flawless Finish Skin Caring Foundation. There's actually 34 shades, and it is a 24-hour wear. It's a beautiful product. It has hyaluronic acid in it, has vitamin C and E in it. It's a great foundation. I'm going to throw you another question, Tosh. Okay. I know we're over time,
but I want to answer your questions for sure.
So is 10% glycolic acid peel too strong? And I think that depends on who you're asking.
definitely. And all percentages aren't created equal. Okay, guys. So I know a lot of times people are really going out there saying it's this many percentage, it's that many percentage. What's truly important is, what is the pH level of that acid, right? So you guys remember when we were in school learning chemistry, right? That if something is an acid, it's like lemon juice, for example. And if it's a base or alkaline, it's like, you know, soap, okay? Pure soap. So you wanna know the pH of that glycolic. So it's very hard for me to assess one person's glycolic, what, for example, could be buffered. They might have other ingredients that slow down the action of that glycolic acid. And so for that reason, it doesn't truly behave like a pure, unbuffered 10% glycolic. So it's very difficult for me to answer that question. In general, though, 10% is safe for most people as long as you're not dehydrated, your skin is not sun compromised, and that you're going to commit to SPF protection daily. Because when you get into using alpha hydroxy acids like glycolic, it makes you more sun sensitive. So a lot of people go after glycolic acid to fix different things on their skin, but they don't do the sun protection commitment, and it actually creates the same issue over and over again for them. So that would be the best answer I could give you on that without knowing specifics, okay?
My product for somebody who is 60 with not a lot of wrinkles and has noticed bigger pores around their eye area.
Retinol eye cream. I know you guys are probably tired of me saying retinol, but it's an in ingredient, and our formulations of it are so amazing because it's not just retinol. So it's all the other replenishing ingredients that help with the eye area. Retinol is one of the best ingredients around the eye area because it helps with some of those pore inconsistencies, things like milias, things like pore enlargement, lines, all kinds of issues, dark circles, puff. I mean, it's an ingredient for a reason, but our formulation in our eye cream is very good. Now, one of the things that you can do because of your age, if you have a slight tendency for dryness, is you can use our Ceramide Eye Capsule. With that. So you want to kind of partner it so that your retinol is your treatment and your retinol eye cream is your treatment product for the eye at night. And then you doing more nourishing and replenishing of the eye area during the day with our capsules, our eye capsules, or our Ceramide Eye Cream, Lift and Firm Eye Cream.
I think that's a great answer. The Ceramide Eye Capsules under makeup is a makeup artist's favorite. Okay. And we hear it all the time. It's a great daytime option when you're trying to recover, especially if you're treating with that retinol.
Absolutely.
So yeah, I have a question.
Sure. Yes,
so I'm fellow esthetician. So okay. In school, I worked a lot with younger folks. I say probably under 30. Now, you know, my clientele is a bit older in their 70s. And so I'm wondering about like the serums, because as you were talking about the different makeups of products, I try to be very careful when I'm using different modalities, like for dermaplaning or microdermaplaning and stuff like that. And I wanted to get your opinion on, like, I don't want to put something on their skin afterwards. It's going to burn them to death.
Right.
So would you say that, because, you know, a lot of my clients use Elizabeth. And so that's why I'm checking this out. Would you recommend that for those types of modalities? Or is it one in particular? I deal mostly with... of course, the wrinkles and liver spots.
Okay. So hey, sis, you're like one of my Estie friends, right? So yes. So when your clients come to you, they're getting a more intensive or active treatment, right? And that's totally appropriate. So your dermaplaning, your microdermabrasion, microneedling, all of those things are appropriate, right? The Elizabeth Arden products are excellent, specifically our ceramide assortment, okay? Specifically our ceramide assortment coming off of intensive treatments. It's kind of what is known now as skin cycling. You're going to cycle down into your nourishing and replenishment. So that's when they would use their advanced ceramide capsules, their lift and firm cream. They're focusing on moisture balance, hydration, nutrient replacement, right? And then they either can cycle back up with you in treatment, in a treatment room treatment, or you can then teach them how to use our more active, because we do have more actives like our retinols, our progressive renewal treatment, which is a series of chemical, you know, peels, AHA peels, and polyhydroxy acids as well. So you would cycle down for nutrient replacement, and then their treatment intensively is in the treatment room with you. So this is totally appropriate. You want to help them understand, you know, what, because each thing that you're doing is addressing the issue from a different angle. And there's always different angles you can approach an issue or, you know, for a solution. So you just want to help them understand their treatment program and how their products fit into their treatment program.
Thank you.
You're very welcome. And that's been one of the things that I love, guys, is that the Elizabeth Arden collection of products play well with professional treatments, other products, you know, if you happen to get in prescriptives, especially that advanced ceramide capsule and my new favorite, the advanced light capsule, because I'm combo oily skin, it helps to replenish and replace and kind of reset your, you know, your middle point on your skin. So you can do more active things and have more active treatments, but then you got to come back center. Okay.
As you're constantly reminding me of when I'm doing my recreational retinol things, and you're like, okay, so where's your advanced capsule? That is the advice she gives me constantly, and it is very good advice. we've got a couple questions about mousse foundation. Can you talk to us about mousse foundation and the wearability of it? And then also the best foundation for women over 50.
So it's hard to say women over 50, because as we have seen today, 50 doesn't look the same on everybody, right? So you kind of got to find textures that you like, right? Mousse foundation is a beautiful formulation. The texture is beautiful. It's wearable. It's not going to fall into any cracks, crevices, or creases, you know, on well moisturized and balanced skin. So, I mean, I don't know, you know, Melissa, it's a beautiful texture for those that like that more lightweight mousse texture. Me, myself, I do a little bit more buildable coverage. So skin caring foundation is good for me because I like to build the layers of for coverage, right? Where mousse is a little lighter. But listen, if you got great skin, you don't have to use a lot of foundation, right? So it's up to you and it's your personal preference. I'm on camera a lot and that kind of thing, right? So if you got to find something that suits your lifestyle. Now, as far about over 50, you do want things like skin caring foundation would be phenomenal because, like Melissa said, the hyaluronic acid, the vitamin C and E, those are other skincare ingredients that are also in the foundation. So that you're getting that extra dose of plumping and hydration and antioxidant protection, right? So that's a good choice for that reason. But you got to try different textures and then wear them for your lifestyle to see how the texture plays with your lifestyle.
I agree. I love the mousse foundation, but I'm not a full coverage foundation wearer. So it does have a thin coverage to it where if I do need to be on camera, I would typically use our flawless finish. So yeah, that's a good point. It really depends on, you know, most people nowadays have more than one formulation of foundation.
Yes. Yes.
So, clarifying for dark spots. Somebody asked, when would you use the clarifying for dark spots? And I'm not sure if that's a specific product you're asking about, or if you're asking about how to address dark spots.
Okay. So I would need clarification on that to really kind of understand it.
Linda.
I purchased the product that's the clarifying that you're supposed to, you know, put on the dark spots. I was just wondering about that product.
So a lot of those spot treatments, if it is a spot treatment, then you're supposed to dot it on areas of concern. And it can take, usually with those kinds of spot treatments, you want to give it at least 6 weeks. Up to 12 weeks, because remember I said that cell renewal cycle. So what happens is we're looking at skin that had bad messaging from a little while ago. So now we're sending new messaging to basement cells. And so those basement cells got to take a minute to come to the surface. So I would say at least 6 weeks of spotting. Then what you also want to do is just address your overall brightness to your complexion. So a lot of times we will pair that, for example, with like our vitamin C's, or a Provage 2.0s, or, you know, it really, a lot of our products have overall brightening benefits. So you want to clarify the overall complexion while you're also treating the spots and make sure that you're wearing daily sun protection, because the sun then disrupts the signals that we're trying to do to those basement skin cells.
Is that, thank you. Question, Linda?
Okay, yes. Thank you very much.
You're very welcome.
Do we have any other questions?
We have any other pressing questions? I see you guys got really excited. We're going to have to do this more often, huh?
Yeah. We had a whole thing we wanted to talk about with you guys. You are the stars of our show today. We really appreciate all of your questions and your thought that you're putting into your skin. Your efforts do really show. You all look amazing.
They do. And so I just want to say, like, you know, kind of back to basics. So if I had my basic, remember I talked in the beginning about those three core steps, right? So you're going to do a good cleansing routine. You want to make sure that your cleanser is not stripping your skin or causing any tightness or irritation after you've cleansed, okay? Then you want to do your treatment step. And that could be anything. We talked about a number of products today. So you can switch up your treatment products. You don't have to pile them all on at once, okay? You can pick certain treat days for yourself and that kind of thing. It's like doing different exercises. Some days you do yoga, sometimes you do aerobics, sometimes you do weights, right? So you do your treatment step as step two, and then you look at your protection. Now, during the day, that should include your final step being of your skincare routine being a sunscreen. And at night, the way you want to do that step is of something that's going to put back what we naturally lose, or we lose because we're stressed, or we lose because, you know, all the things that we go through, right? So your nighttime care is important. Let's not forget the eye. And somebody said, what order do I use it? So I clean my skin, then I put my eye products on, then I put my serums on, then I put my eye products on, then I seal it all in face and neck with sun protection in general. Now, there are some products that require you to use them a little differently, and you always want to go to lightest, from lightest to heaviest textures, just to recap, right? And you want to always, no matter what, use sun protection during the day, because our environment is reversing all of the work that we're trying to do to make our skin optimally healthy. Okay.
Really good advice today.
Yeah.
I told you earlier, I thought maybe I'm using too much product, because I forgot to tell you I use toner after I cleanse. I told her. So it's like, can you overdo it? Like trying to do too much to your skin?
Because remember I said your skin is a live, healthy organ. It's your largest living organ. Your skin is alive. It's constantly telling on you, right? So if you're overdoing it, you pay attention to things like a little redness, small bumps, a little irritation. Your skin feels uncomfortable. If you're overdoing it, then back off. And there's nothing wrong with, like I said, switching it up. You have a great regimen, you know your steps, but sometimes you need to switch out similar products. So you don't need 2 day creams. You pick a day cream with SPF, right? And so you do that. Your skin is smart, okay? A lot of times you're not going to necessarily overdo it. You're really just using product and it's not doing much for you. So you're wasting your product. So it is important that you understand what to use when so that you get the best results so that your skin's not full. It's like putting, when your eyes get bigger than your appetite, right? You've heard that saying before.
Yeah.
And we get all this food on our plate and then you're like, it's at the buffet kind of thing. And you get all this stuff on your plate and there's no way you can eat all that. Your skin is got to take it in gradual, healthy doses. So you want to look at your regimen as your gradual, healthy doses.
Is it necessary to use toner? Because I've been using it for...
It depends. Now, that's a very personal thing. A lot of our cleansers don't require a toning step. However, certain skin types are seasoned to toning steps. And it also depends on the toners you use. Our ceramide toner is amazing. So I don't know. I can't give you a definitive answer. It depends. I try not to tell you the it depends answer, but in this case, it really depends on what else you're doing. I don't think there's any harm in you using your toner based on some of the other products that you mentioned, just because you're not stripping down your skin too much. You're actually putting good things back. So then I'm not concerned if you continue to use your toner.
Okay.
Okay.
All right. I'm going to continue.
Gosh, I'm going to give you one last question, and it's because we all want to know, if we were stranded on a desert island, what are the three products that you would be your must-have products? Because it's always interesting to hear from an esthetician, like, they are great at giving us advice, but what is in their bag? What is in their skincare routine? So if you, the rest of your life on a desert island, what are you taking?
So let me be the first to say, I sin with my skin not as much as I used to when I was young, because I am getting to a place that my skin tells on me a lot faster. So I'm not, a golden girl when it comes to that either. Okay. I have been known to sleep in my makeup when I was younger. I've learned the hard way not to do that now. So what would be, if I were a desert island, product number one would be, and Lori, thanks for sharing yours, because I was going to say, I'm curious to know, what would be your three products? I have to have my SPF.
Yeah.
So I love our Provage City Smart product. I have to have antioxidant protection because I'm going to be out there in the environment until I meet a handsome person to help me build a shack of some sort, right? So that's Provage 2.0 Daily Serum. I definitely have recently fallen in love with the Advanced Light Capsules for my combo oily skin, and I really do like that it helps to put back those healthy nutrients and it helps some of the tightness I didn't realize I was experiencing too frequently. And if I can, it's kind of like a wild card. 8-hour skin protected, because I'll be using that head to toe. I will, in my hair, in my brows, on my lips, on my heels, on my cute, like all the things. I'll be scrubbing myself down with the sand and sealing in the moisture with 8-hour skin protection.
Yes.
And a good red lip, like the Red Door Red I'm wearing. Because let's be honest, you feel good when you got that red lip on, and it'll help me forget that I'm there by myself.
I had asked Tosh this earlier today, and she was like, well, can I not take toothpaste and take something else? Because this is how dedicated she is.
I said, I would compromise. I would lose my teeth. I would lose my teeth, because whoever finds me, I'm going to be cute. I'm sorry. I just won't be grinning as hard. So. I'll rinse with the salt water. That's fine.
Is there anybody in Palm Beach County in any place that you like that you can see in person? Do you know anybody in Palm Beach?
Florida? Oh, gosh. I actually do know someone. I don't know if she's still doing facials, though. So, no, I do not have an overt recommendation, but I will say that I know there are some very talented estheticians that, even now, guys, there's some phenomenal franchises popping up and that kind of thing. You don't need a super sophisticated facial. You can graduate to that if that's where you choose to go. So just go and give it a try. Go and give it a try. You guys are savvy and sophisticated. You know what you want. Just communicate with your esthetician. I think the biggest misconception, if I may, is that we're not relatable. We got into this for you. We committed our career for you. So you tell us what you want and need, and we usually adjust and accommodate to you. So it looks like we had a full hour.
We did have a full hour. So this was great. We need to plan more of these, and we will.
Yes.
We are going to attempt to, again, to come back and stump the esthetician at some point in the near future. Right now, as somebody mentioned earlier, on ElizabethArden.com, if you're shopping for a moisturizer or an eye cream, if you use the code moisturizer, Posh, what is the discount?
50%.
Yeah. Okay. Such a good deal to shop right now. And
such a good deal.
Like, I was like, really? That's awesome. For
yeah, the code is moisturize. So drop a one in the chat if you feel like you can grab a moisturizer. Drop a one in a chat if you feel like you can go and shop for a good new moisturizer.
I'm going.
Some ones. Can I get a one? Yes. Okay, Lori. All right. So I got one person that can commit to moisturizer, guys. Can I get a one in the chat if you learned about sun protection? That's 50% off also today.
Two, how about a two of you do eye cream? Who's doing eye cream?
Yeah, a couple eye creams, the 8-hour protective. Oh, right, ordered superstart. Okay, Kieran. Okay, I love to see that. Okay. All right, my loves. Keep taking care of yourself until we see you again.
Thank you so much.
Have a wonderful day, everybody. Thank you so much. Thank you, Tosh. Bye-bye.